Hello students, welcome to Maggie's classes. In this video, we are going to discuss about easy way to find the number of structural isomers. This presentation is very useful to plus two chemistry and NEET IIT JEE aspirants. In examination, we have come across find the number of isomers for the molecular formula C4H10O. So this represents alcohol and ethers. So what is the way to find the number of isomers? It is 4 or 5. This video helps you to find the number of isomers of the various molecular formula like acids, aldehydes, ketones, esters, ethers, etc. So it is a very simple way to find the number of structural isomers. So I hope that it will be useful to you. So keep on watching till the end of the video. Let us move into the video. Let us see the finding of number of isomers for the molecular formula. Before that, we have to remember the number of carbon and the number of isomers. So, number of carbon and the number of isomers. If the carbon number is 1, the number of isomer is 1. Carbon number 2, isomers 1. Carbon number is 3, the isomer is 2. Carbon number is 4, isomers 4, and carbon number 5, the number of isomers 8. So let us see one example. For example, C4H10O. So what are the possible isomers for this molecular formula? See, so this compound is having the general formula of the alcohol, that is CN H2N plus 1OH and ether. So alcohols of the formula C4H9OH. Ether may be ROR. First, find the number of alcohols. See this compound having 4 carbon atom, that is carbon is 4. What is isomer C? So number of alcohol isomer is 4. In case of ether, the 4 carbons split into C, C, C. So here 1 carbon and here 3 isopropyl groups. The number of carbon is 3. This side, the bulky side you have to see. So number of carbon is 3. But write the unsymmetrical and symmetrical ethers. When C is equal to 3, what is the isomers, number of isomers? It is 2. Okay. And by altering the number of carbons, in this case C, C, O, ether, C, C. See the number of carbon is 2. So number of isomer is 1. And again you increase the C, C, here O. So this is similar to the first structure. So the structure is similar to the third one. So total number of isomers, here the ether isomer is 3. So total isomers, total isomers is equal to 4 from alcohol and 3 from ether. So, clear? So number of isomers of the molecular formula C4H10O is 7, 4 alcohols and 3 ethers. Let's see the other example. Other example C5H12. So this is the alcohol and the ether. So alcohol, what is the formula? C5H11OH. So number of carbon 5. So if number of carbon is 5, what is the number of isomers? I is equal to 8. Clear? In case of ethers. Ethers, you can write this 1 carbon on the left hand side and another 4 carbon. So if 4 carbon atoms are there, what is the number of isomers? You can write simply. Okay, then to alter the structure, here is 2 and here 3 carbon atom. If 3 carbon atom is present, what is the number of isomers? 2. Okay, and it is raised C, 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 3 and O, C, C. So it is similar to that of your second observation. Okay, So you cannot write this structure. Okay. So what else? What is other possibilities? The other possibilities are, there is no other possibilities. Here the 1 carbon, 4 carbon, and 2 and 3. And if you write 3 here, you have 1. So the structure is repeated. So total number of ether isomers are 6. So what is the total isomers? You can write total isomers is equal to alcohol isomers 8 and ether isomers 6. Totally 14 isomers for this one. Okay. Let us see the other examples. Aldehyde compound. The general molecular formula CnH2nO. CnH2nO. So this is the aldehyde. So aldehyde as well as this molecule may represent, this molecular formula represent ketone also. Okay, first aldehyde. Aldehyde having the formula, what is the formula? C3H7CH. This is correct. Aldehyde is a functional group. Now see, it is a number of carbon atom. This compound is 3. So carbon 3. So isomer is 2. So aldehyde isomer 2. What about ketone? Ketone having the functional group C double bond O, and the group is flanked with alkyl group. So one is there. So here C, and here C. So you can write only 2. So number of carbon 2, the number of isomer is 1. So what's the total isomers from aldehyde? Total isomer is equal to aldehyde it is 2, and from ketone it is 1. So total 3. Clear? So in this way you have to write other isomers. Now take to the acid. So an acid. Acid molecular formula C5H10O. General formula. You can write this C4H9COOH acid. So here see, number of carbon in the acid group. The carbon is in the 4. So N is equal to 4. So what is your isomer? I is equal to isomers. Acid and esters are functional isomers. So you can write esters also for this compound. So esters C double bond O here. O. So the ester group. And one carbon here. And the remaining carbons, number of carbon is 3. So C. So it's a typical ester. Here you see number of carbon atom is 3. So I is equal to 2 for this. And what is the other structures? C double bond C double bond O C. So you kind of you can count the number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, the number of carbon is 2. Then I is equal to 1. So ester isomers are 3. So total isomers, the acid isomers is equal to 4. And ester isomer is equal to 3. So total 7. Shall we move to the next example? That is amines. Amines having general molecular formula NH2NHN. It is the primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine. Now see one example. Calculate the number of possible isomers for this amine C4H11N. Okay, first primary amine. Primary amine, you write C4H9NH2. This is the primary amine. So the 2 hydrogen is changed into NH. So what are the number of carbon in this formula? It is carbon number is 4. So corresponding isomers is equal to 4. Okay, next to the secondary amine. Secondary amine you can write, that is NH group. Here one carbon and here other 3 carbons. You have to split the 4 carbon into 1 plus 3. See this side, the number of carbon is 3. So you can write number of isomers 2. Then change the groups on either side of the nitrogen atom. So C and C, here NH, C. So total number of carbon atoms on this one group is 2. So corresponding isomer is equal to 1. So then there is no probable shifting of group is Then what is the change in the carbon group? See, so it is one, it will be one and it will be three. So the same structure is repeated. So number of isomer is three. Clear? Then tertiary amine. Tertiary amines is C, N, C, and one side it will be C and C. Okay, so these are the alkyl groups. See here, the number of carbon atom is 2. The number of isomers 1. So tertiary amines, the number of isomer is. So what is the total isomers? Total is equal to primary 4 and secondary 2 and tertiary 1. So 7 isomers. So this molecular formula gives 7 isomers, 4 for primary amine, 3 for secondary. So it will be 3 plus 1, total 8 isomers, 4 for primary amine and 3 for secondary amine and 1 for tertiary, total 8 isomers. Clear? Okay, I hope that it is very useful to you. So we will see in the next presentation with a different idea. Thank you for watching.